Alright guys, we're going back to the Eagle Stand. Patula's going climb on a select cut that they did. We'll see what happens. Hopefully we get a pig or something. What you think, Patula?
Gotta try.
He looks enthused.
Yeah, don't spit on the camera.
Where you going?
Spot. I'm gonna park the bike here, pull the key. I'm gonna grab my bag, the camera and all. I got about a 400 yard walk to a double ladder stand. Going back there, hopefully something happens. Hey look, whenever possible, you take the little ditches. It kind of helps cover your scent. It don't have a lot of water, but the mud's gonna help on the bottom of your boot kill some of the scent. Hopefully that big bastard will come in. I'll be able to smoke him. Let me hit him right there in the neck. I've been trying to catch this pig for over a year now. Here's some footage from a few months ago near the hog trap I set up where he lives. I'm going to check my trap, see if I caught big bastard in it. That son of a gun, every time I bait it, he just goes around the trap and then he eats all the corn on the outside. I'm going to go check, see if I got him. I fixed the feeder, that way it don't spit corn outside the trap. Son of a gun. He's uprooting all around the trap. He wants the acorns, he don't want that corn. Special feed didn't do good. The problem is you bait him, and you're only baiting him for 2 days on the weekend warriors like me. So, anyway, it's supposed to rain later today. I bet you he comes in here after I open the gate, and he's gonna come mop that up in one night. I might not be able to catch him in a trap. I might have to pop him with the rifle. Check out what I use to keep the straight chute in the trap. That way big bastard can't get it. Some siding from my house. Some extra I had from the hurricane. So I made a guard where it just falls underneath the feeder. That's a straight chuter. That look like some blueberries or something. The shit is that? If y'all know what that is, give me a shout out. Let me know. It's all around this pig sign. I wonder if they're eating that. Look at the tree. It lost all its leaves and these blueberries are falling. Maybe it's a blueberry bush, huh? Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Press the little green button or to subscribe. Help some brothers out. Almost to the stand. I'm going real quiet. I take 3 steps and I stop. I'm about 8 yards. It's gonna take me about 15, 20 minutes. Don't be in a hurry.
mosquitoes are bad in these bottoms. When there's litter in the woods, use that to mark your trail. There's the ladder. Most important part. Don't F it up by your stand. Real slow, watch the branches.
Another finding. Hunting these pine woods. Look like somebody at all. Come in here and thin cut. And you barely see. They still left it kind of thick around the box. This is a toss-up. Got a food plot this way. Men said there's a scrape over there somewhere. Hopefully a buck come out just before dark. Hopefully he's gonna come on the back side of that. And that comes out the road over here. If he makes a scrape, we'll probably catch him. It is on the other side of him with the wind blowing in his face, I believe. And he's kind of hit me on the back. So my sense blowing this way towards the camera. The food plot's right there. He's got a box stand back this way. I decided not to go in there. But we fixing to see.
These mosquitoes are horrible. It's cold weather. We still got mosquitoes in Louisiana. Don't make no sense. That's what an eagle was. Not the branch. Branch fell about 8 feet away from me. Like to knock me out.
The eagle dropped the bass.
He brought me a fish. Check that out. E.T. phone home. Watching this ridge. Got northeast wind. The ridge runs from northeast to southwest. The wind's parallel to the ridge. It's about 25 yards to the northwest of me. When I first found this, it was flooded back here. They had some beaver dams. But the last 2 years, it's been dry. When it was flooded, the deer were following the ridge. They had a big rub line. We used to hunt in situations like that here in South Louisiana. They like to walk the ridges out the water.
Gotcha, piggy. Big mother fricker. You big ugly pig. Pig patrol.
Got me a piggy. Pork chops, baby.
Mitch just shot a big pig. Got one on the ground. And he texted me that they got a young man. Got a buck on the ground somewhere. Shot at him. He ran off. So we're going to be probably looking for a buck unless they find it before Hopefully he's got it and it's just right there in the woods.
All right, we're going to look for that big pig. I think I got him. He fell in the ditch, as y'all saw on camera.
Sound like a good hit from where I was at.
Oh, yeah. He crumbled in between the front shoulder and the head. Blah! Knock him down. Let's go get him.
That's a crooked tree. There it is. See that crooked tree? That's where he went. There's another ditch. Get the gun ready. Stand by. I see him. I see something glowing right there. Boy, he buried himself. Pull. I smell him from here. Pull. Yeah. Just. Yeah, he's out for the count. Ugh. Big nasty pig, boy.
Yeah, see them teeth, y'all? Don't want to run into him in the dark, huh? Look how sharp that one is. That's the one that was scraping
sharp.
His teeth on that deer run.
You'll end up biting it. I don't think you want to do that. Watch them teeth be sharp.
Well, big bastard came in upwind. I think he crossed my walking trail and he stopped. And I'm like, oh man, did he see me in the stand? So I froze. I had the camera on him. He came to 20 yards. I hollered at him or I grunted or something. I don't know. I was excited. He stopped and I put it in him, dropped him right there with that hog hammer. Got that hog hammer ammo. Knocked him down.
Yes, you take a look at this thing.
I'm a big dude. Look at the smoke coming out of it. I shot bigger pigs, but a good pig's a dead pig.
That's how you do it.